Excellence for All is a national pilot program designed to make American high schools more globally competitive. Arizona is one of four states participating in the program with an initiative called Move On When Ready. The pilot project is based on years of research by the National Center on Education and the Economy. We'll hear from that organization's president in just a moment. But first, David Major takes us to one of 14 Arizona schools that are participating in the program.
We are going to do quick draw debates today.
These ninth grade students have an opportunity to earn a high school diploma by the end of their sophomore year.
Should the U.S. have helped the League of Nations? Dwayne, begin.
It should, because it was the creator of the Treaty of Versailles.
They're part of a pilot program called Move On When Ready. ASU Preparatory Academy in downtown Phoenix, a charter school operated by ASU, is one of 14 Arizona schools participating in the first year of the program.
We are really preparing students for the rigors of college, for post-secondary study.
Deborah Gonzalez is ASU Prep's chief academic officer.
We've actually changed the course-taking sequence so that students can get core requirements out of the way early. The level of rigor is definitely different.
It would cost us extra money to support other people's problems, their own greedy nature of wanting more and more land, more and more control over more and more things.
With the Move On When Ready curriculum that students are looking at, it's more about the way students think and the way students apply their knowledge in new and different settings.
Okay, what are other reasons that Britain and France thought appeasement was the right thing at the right time? Donna?
Move On When Ready schools use a State Board of Education approved curriculum from a world-class provider like Cambridge International Examinations.
We purposely chose Cambridge because of that competing globally aspect. It was important to us that we had something that was an international benchmarked curriculum.
Students who pass the Cambridge exams in history, English, math, and science are considered academically ready for college or career.
The door doesn't open and we're kicking them out. The door opens wider so that they have another range of opportunities available to them.
They can earn a Grand Canyon diploma and move on to pursue other interests. They can enroll in a community college, or they can stay in high school and take college-level courses.
Our job is to make sure that by the time they've reached that BES examination and demonstrated their readiness, that readiness is really an indicator that whatever they choose to do, they can do it and be successful.
Our debate went well because we both agreed that the...
And joining me now to talk about his organization's efforts to improve public education in Arizona and around the country is Mark Tucker, president of the National Center for Education and the Economy. Good to have you here. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me, Ted.
Excellence for All, the pilot program, in broad terms, what are we talking about here?
So we have been doing research on the countries that year after year top the international league tables in terms of student performance. And the idea is very simple. Because the United States is far behind them now, the question is, what are they doing that we're not doing that we need to do in order to match their performance? Over all those years, one of the major findings, our own and many others who have done the same kind of work, is that countries that top the lists typically have at the high school level what they call board examination systems, which means, it's actually a terrible phrase because it doesn't explain what it means very well, but basically they have a set curriculum. And for each of the courses in that curriculum, it's the same for all students, they have a really high quality syllabus, they have very high quality exams that are set to the course, as defined by the syllabus, and they train their teachers to teach those courses. That's what the system is. So it's very coherent, aligned, powerful system of instruction. When we look at the United States, we don't have any of that, actually. And so what we did was something very simple. We looked all over the world and we asked ourselves, where are the most powerful board exam systems, really instructional systems, anywhere in the world that are available in English for use in the United States? We divided them into two bundles. One of the are the systems that are available for use in the freshman and sophomore years, the other for the ones that are available for use in the junior and senior years. And we looked for schools for our pilot that said, we are willing to use one of the ones, the top ones that you, meaning us, have found for use in the freshman and sophomore years, and we're going to offer to our students one of the very best ones that you found for use in the junior and senior years. Now, one of the other things that the top performing countries do is they say, we're going to have a system in which what you're expected to achieve by the end of the common education experience, usually by the end of age 16, those are the requirements for going on to the next step. So the two parts of the system are matched. If you reach this requirement, you're good to go for the next step. So we said, we'll do that. We'll take these lower division courses and programs, and we'll set a passing standard for them that is the level of literacy in math and in English that's required to be successful in a community college. And we've said, kids, if you can achieve that at the end of your sophomore or junior or senior year, you go right to community college if that's what you want to do.
I can already hear critics saying, benchmarks, exams, teaching to the test, not getting a well-rounded education, but trying to hit each focal point. How do you respond?
They're right about the American system because our standards are so low and we're teaching only to English and math. This is a program about the whole core curriculum. So it's world history, it's American history, it's biology, it's physics, excuse me, it's chemistry, it's art, it's physical ed, it's the whole core curriculum. And the tests that are being used, the rest of the world does not use the kinds of tests that we use, the computer-scored multiple choice fill-in-the-bubble tests. They make you think. So getting ready for one of those tests isn't just a matter of memorizing a few things. You have to really understand what you've studied. They're great tests.
Is there a will in this country, though? These all sound like fantastic, interesting ideas, certainly something to consider, something to throw out in a test pilot program. But unless you have students, parents, communities, all interested, and I mean interested, in education, making sure Junior gets through these classes and helps and mentors and does the whole nine. If you don't have that, what kind of program can you really pursue?
You know, my board, I brought my board out here from all over the country to look at the way this program is evolving now in this state. And we had a group of people from the Yuma School District presenting to us for about 2 hours. It was phenomenal. Many of the teachers, when they realized what the standards are for this program and how high they are and how difficult the work is for kids, when they first saw it, said, forget it, I'm not doing that, I'm out of here. When they saw what the kids actually started to do, the kind of work that they were really capable of doing if they were challenged, they changed their mind entirely.
Interesting.
They really rose to the occasion. Yuma is not, as you know, a top performer. It's not Scottsdale. It's a lot more like your average community anywhere in this country. And to see these teachers rising to the occasion that way, it was astonishing.
Last question. We just recently had yet another report regarding American education, this one suggesting that national security was being threatened, and that the nature of American society, the cohesive nature of society, just getting along with each other, that could be compromised because of poor education and folks not learning what they need to learn, advancing and developing as they should. Do you agree with that?
I do agree with that, and I can tell you very briefly why. Most American historians and foreign policy analysts are now agreed that military might in the world we have today is a function of national economic strength, very closely tied together. You don't have big world-class armies unless you have world-class economies to sustain them. It is very clear in the global economy that we have that what you make as an individual or as a country is more a function of what you know than it has ever been before. And you can see this in the numbers. People with more education are making more and more money relative to people who get less. The United States is spending more money per capita on education than any other country in the industrialized world except a tiny principality in Europe. And our performance is in the drink. It's mediocre. It's right in the middle of the distribution. If we don't fix that, we will not be able to afford a world-class military. And that will be the end of us.
Mark, it's good to have you here. Good discussion. Thanks for joining us. We appreciate it.
Thank you.